Hello everyone. I am Pastor Bum Son Hong. I am pastor of Centenary United Methodist Church in Louisiana, Missouri, and also pastor of Clarksville United Methodist Church in Clarksville, Missouri. Last Sunday, I preached about the greatest commandment from Jesus and the meaning of a worship service. Love of Jesus is prior to any commandment. And for John Wesley, love of Jesus is the same as the grace of God, because God gave us His grace as unmerited gift of love. God's good intention always towards us to save us and to love us. Thus, it was the most important when he disputed with another theologians about the theological issue or conflict. United Methodist highly recommend infant baptism, for example. I'd like to talk about the story, an argument about infant baptism, about John Wesley. At the time of John Wesley, theologians were arguing about infant baptism. Is it okay to do that or not? Most of them said, infant shouldn't be baptized because baptism is a moment of commitment, decision, confession, and rebirth. People should know about meaning of sin and meaning of salvation to do that. However, infant, this little baby, doesn't know it. Thus, infant baptism is not valid, and it makes less meaningful of a baptism. However, for John Wesley, infant baptism is a gift of God. How can human being stop this God's intention of salvation for the baby? Of course, infant cannot think meaning of a baptism and cannot make a commitment and cannot know about sin. But their parents knows. Thus, infant baptism is the moment to feel work of God and grace of God and love of Jesus, as well as parents' commitment to nurture their child with Christian faith. When people said infant baptism is wrong, John Wesley said, it is not wrong. However, in now, some people think not taking infant baptism is wrong. That's not Wesley's intention. Wesley didn't say you must baptize your baby, but what he said was infant baptism is not wrong. It is not about ritual or policy or rule. It is about grace of God and how God works on us. Thus, when you have theological question or biblical question or conflict in your mind, I strongly encourage you to think about how does God's grace of God and love of Jesus work on your question, rather than think about it is right or wrong, or is it sin or right or justice. God's grace and love are eternal. We believe forgiveness of sins and salvation. But please remember, it doesn't mean that you can make sin. Please don't make cheap the grace of God. It is free, but not cheap. Don't consider the grace of God as like a detergent for sin. So let us think about meaning of grace and love of Jesus, so that Let us glorify God, for that His love endures forever. So let's glorify God's name, so that He, because He gave grace and He gave us love. So let's think about this meaning, and let's think about His intention. So thank you for watching this video. So I hope you have a good day and good week, and I hope to see you next time. So please be in safe and be peace with the grace of God. Amen.